Mr. Speaker, H.R. 4007 authorized the Chemical Facility Anti-Terrorism Standards, or CFATS, program through 2017 and came through regular order. As a lead author of the original legislation to establish DHS's Chemical Security Program, I have consistently supported efforts for this committee to advance freestanding authorizing legislation to ensure that the program, which was stood up pursuant to a paragraph in the 2007 appropriation bill, was authorized. Until today, the closest Congress has come to replacing that appropriation language with a more detailed and comprehensive bill was in 2010, when the House unanimously approved legislation I authored with then Energy and Commerce Chairman Henry Waxman. H.R. 4007 bears little resemblance to that measure. However, there are a few provisions that are in the spirit of the prior bill, such as worker protection in the development of security plans and provision of basic whistleblower protections to workers who risk their jobs to come forward to report security issues. I appreciate the contributions made to the legislation by the chairman of the Senate Homeland Security Committee, particularly with respect to whistleblower rights and the personnel surety program, two areas championed by subcommittee ranking member Clark and committee Democrats. I'm pleased that Democratic efforts to prevent regulatory overreach by DHS with respect to personnel surety ultimately prevail, so that under this bill, facilities would have a range of options for how to ensure that individuals accessing their facilities are vetted. The bill also grants DHS new authorities to identify and bring into compliance facilities that willfully ignore this federal regulatory program, putting their workers and surrounding communities at risk. This so-called outlier provision is in direct response to Chemical Safety Board findings regarding the deadly fire and damaging explosions at the West Fertilizer Company in Texas in April of 2013. The board determined that they were preventable and that it was due in part to inability of federal, state, and local agencies to identify a serious hazard and correct it. Though I support a multi-year authorization for CFATS, and there are a number of provisions in the bill that I fully support, there is one in the bill, as considered today, that could very well undermine the effectiveness of the entire program. I am, of course, speaking of the language authored by a ranking member of the Senate committee that directs DHS to establish a so-called expedited approval program, or as I have come to see it, as a self-certification program. Yes, you hear me right. Under this program, some facilities would be able to self-certify that they are in compliance with the risk-based performance standards under the program. The population of facilities that would be eligible represents about 70% of all facilities subject to this regulatory program. The inclusion of this provision, which requires DHS within 180 days to issue guidance to facilities on how to access self-certification, has not gone through the rigor of intensive and balanced bicameral legislative debate or discussion. It lacks a legislative history. Allowing certain CFATS-covered facilities to independently certify that the security plans they develop meet statutory requirement is an inherently risky approach that leaves DHS with few options. Given the resource challenges and chronic backlog challenges in the CFATS program, I have trouble believing that self-certified facilities would receive timely inspections where misrepresentations, omissions, and inadequacies with the plans could be identified. Defenders of this provision have argued my concerns about turning back the clock on security are misplaced. I certainly hope so. If this measure is enacted into law, as I expect will occur, we will know within a very few short period of time the CFATS office effectively design and launch a new program within its program that is consistent with risk-based, performance-based standards. H.R. 4007 certainly has the potential to be an oversight goldmine, giving the Committee on Homeland Security plenty of time to dig into during the next Congress. Despite my deep concerns with the self-certification program, I will be voting in favor of H.R. 4007. I will be casting an aye vote to get the CFATS program off the erratic appropriation cycle and give some predictability to the facilities that are regulated under the program and the men and women that look to DHS to partner effectively with the facilities to help keep them secure. With that, Mr. Speaker, I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman reserves the balance of his